The Sony Xperia E-Series has a challenging task set upon it, to convince buyers within the competitive low-end market to pick it up over increasingly strong alternatives. But the Xperia E5 seems stronger than its predecessors, with significantly better hardware in essentially every area. On paper, it's a worthy successor, but sold for the equivalent of about $210 in Europe, is that enough to make it a success? This is Chris with Phone Arena, let's take a closer look. If there's one thing the Xperia E5 has going for it, it's design. Unlike previous E-line devices, which looked decidedly low-end, one would have a hard time calling this anything but attractive. In typical Sony style, the E5's form factor is that of a pleasantly rounded rectangle. The phone is entirely made out of polycarbonate, but honestly it feels solid and well constructed. The backplate has a matte finish, which despite everything actually makes this a far more ergonomically sound phone than the likes of the Xperia Z5. Sony fans, however, will be quick to notice the missing and kind of signature dedicated physical shutter key. We also felt that the volume rocker, located on the upper side of the frame, is a bit too far for comfortable use, even with larger than average hands. That said, the power key is well in reach and both buttons offer a satisfying click when pressed. Upgrading upon the resolution of its predecessor, the E5 features a 5-inch 720p pixel display of the LCD type, ensuring an adequate viewing experience, though some graininess is actually noticeable. In terms of screen properties, the E5 doesn't disappoint and brings peak brightness of over 500 nits, so you won't have to strain your eyes too much under direct sunlight. Finally, core accuracy is pretty decent for a device of this caliber. We've got an excellent core temperature, decently accurate gamma across the brightness spectrum, and relatively lifelike cores for the most part. Based on Android Marshmallow, the Xperia E5 comes with Sony's custom skin on top, which has seen some low-key but meaningful updates in terms of visuals. The user interface is more colorful than before, with a set of striking wallpapers, but it's still a traditionally contained and self-respecting Sony implementation. In terms of functionality, there are a few neat extras, such as support for Teams. Beyond that, however, you're looking at a very true-to-stock Android experience. Finally, despite fingerprint scanners having started making their way into the lower end, the Xperia E5 makes do without one. Like its predecessors, the Xperia E5's number-crunching prowess is the work of a MediaTek processor. More specifically, we're treated to a chipset with 4 cores and a dual-core Mali graphics processor. RAM sits at 1.5 GB. In our experience, this combination will serve any but the most discerning and demanding users greatly. General interface navigation is fluid and response times are fast enough as to be tolerable. For those of us looking to do some casual gaming every now and then, be sure that the Xperia E5 is perfectly up to the task, managing even somewhat heavier titles without too much trouble. AAA titles heavy on visuals, however, tend to be a bit too much on the GPU and frame rate suffers noticeably. As for storage, you're limited to 16 GB, of which about 10 GB are available to use store files. If that's insufficient, which is likely, you can expand through a microSD card. Sony has opted for a 13-megapixel camera with wide f2.0 lens and an LED flash for the E5. Up front, we're also treated to a noticeable upgrade in the form of a 5-megapixel selfie snapper, capable of 1080p video for those video conference chats. Software-wise, as elsewhere, we're treated to a clean interface with the various modes available by swiping up and down on the screen. Of those, however, just 3 are available: Auto, Manual and Video. With Manual, you only get access to a white balance slider and scene selection, which is unfortunate. Turning to image quality, outdoors during the day the camera proved surprisingly capable. Detail is preserved to a very high level, even if on the rather soft side. Still, white balance is set correctly, core is captured fairly accurately and dynamic range was, again, surprisingly good. In darker scenarios during the day, however, the camera tends to favor fast shutter speeds a little too much. In result, some snaps are decidedly darker than in real life. It's when we step inside that we're suddenly shocked to see the Xperia E5 take a huge step back. Scenes are once again less bright than desirable, but even more detrimental is the wildly inaccurate white balance at times. If sufficiently lit, however, shots when inside can also be pretty decent, just as long as the software gets the white balance right. In terms of video, we've got 1080p resolution capture with no optical stabilization or other neat extras in sight. Footage is once again murky looking, but even worse, we found continuous autofocus to be kind of lacking. While the Xperia E4G from last year managed an impressive battery score in our testing, our custom script drained the Xperia E5 after only 6 hours and 10 minutes. This is a strictly average score relative to our entire database. This is doubly true considering the largest 2700 mAh cell and the rather frugal 720p display. Spec sheets and synthetic tests aside, our own experience with the Xperia E5 largely corroborates our results, perhaps missing the mark by just a bit. We were secure in our knowledge that this E5 will make it through the day, but then again, that was with relatively light usage. If you game a lot or like to watch a lot of video, you have to make sure that you charge your phone every night. It's not very often that we get to say this, but it's probably best that, for the time being, you stay clear of the Xperia E5. That's not because it's a problematic device though, the very opposite in fact. As a whole, I was pleasantly surprised by Sony's work with this affordable smartphone, which performed well across the board. So why wait? Put simply, I'd rather wait out and see how the Moto G4 Play and even the slightly more expensive ASUS Zenfone 3 translate into the real world, as both have the potential to be the better buy. Better yet, both are expected to be available in the States, unlike the Xperia E5 it seems. Of course, if you absolutely must go for it now, the Xperia E5 right this moment is worth a buy. Once again, this was Chris with Phone Arena, thank you folks for watching.